All right, everybody. This is going to be office hours for Unit 1. Thank you all for participating so far and taking the class. I hope it's been informative for you so far. That was the easy stuff. So after this unit, we're going to get into some of the tricky things. So Sean's found some questions from the forums that we're going to go through that you guys have all had. So let's go.
OK. Well, the first question is about Google App Engine. And people had a lot of questions about Google App Engine, how it works, how to get it running, problems they had, whether we were going to need to use it. So if we could go over all of that stuff real quick.
OK. So to answer your question first, or to take it from the top, basically, we chose Google App Engine because we thought it would be the easiest way to get up and running, to get a website online. Believe it or not, even after reading the forums, I still believe it's the easiest way to get something online. That said, if you don't want to use it, you don't have to. All of the homeworks are going to be structured with the same basic format, which is submit a URL that does X. So if you can get a URL online that does X, great. So if you want to run this off your local machine, use Apache, whatever, you're allowed to do that. But I'm going to be teaching all the lessons using Google App Engine. That's what I'll be demoing in the class. That's what I'll be working from. And that's generally what I'll be talking about. So the way Google App Engine works, the idea is you're just writing these Python files. And you've got two options of running and distributing your code. You can either use the launcher program, which has got a little play button that allows you to start up your app once you add it to the launcher. And that requires, Google App Engine itself doesn't ship with Python. You need to have Python installed on your machine. And that seems to be where a lot of the trouble is. Google App Engine, there's two versions of it. One will work with Python 2.7 and one will work with 2.5. Nothing in this course requires 2.5 or 2.7 specifically. So just get one of them working and go from there. Now, once you've got your app running locally, then you can either use the launcher to upload the app or you can use the console utility. Personally, I use the console utility. You just say, I think app config update, and then you point it at the directory where your files are. And then it churns for a little while, and then you can go to your account name.appspot.com and see your app. So if you have any specific troubles, post them in the forum. Other students have been really helpful with specific sysadmitting answers and that sort of thing. So keep asking, keep working at it. This first homework is basically just get this thing online. And I know that can be a pain on some of your machines. So let's just get this thing online so we can move onward with the course. And if you want to use something else, knock yourself out. We're not going to be able to help you, but you're free to learn and try it on your own.
OK, next question is from Brian Y. And he wants to know, what are some useful things to know about front-end web app development?
OK, cool. So good question, because we're not going to be spending a whole lot of time on front-end web app development in this class. The main pieces of technology you want to know would be JavaScript and CSS. JavaScript is a separate programming language that runs in the browser. And you serve JavaScript just like you would serve HTML. And you can manipulate your HTML. You can manipulate CSS and that sort of stuff. Google for JavaScript tutorial, and you will have plenty of resources to learn from. And CSS, that's basically another type of file you would serve from your web server, and that controls the styling, the colors, the font sizes, the layout of your HTML. I'll use CSS in this class, and I'll provide you, when we start getting into some of the more complex websites you're going to be building, like when we start doing the blog stuff, I'll point to where my CSS is so you can download that and use it if you want. But for the most part, the way we're doing the grading on all of these homeworks is we're going to have our own piece of software that's basically manipulating your website. And it's really hard for us to see if your website even looks right. So the appearance of things is not something we can really grade anyway. But if you have some professional pride and want to make things look nice, JavaScript and CSS are the technologies you'll want to learn. And you can use those on your own if you want to learn those classes. It's not going to affect how we grade homeworks or anything like that. So good question.
OK. Brian Y has a number of additional questions.
OK.
And one of them is Google App Engine a good solution for large-scale projects? And are there any unforeseen difficulties
okay.
or costs involved with that?
Sure. Well, there are costs. There are literal costs. Google App Engine is free at a small scale, so it'll work for all of our homeworks. But if you want to run it at a larger scale, you've got to pay for the bandwidth you use and how much data you store and that sort of things. I personally haven't used App Engine in production, but Udacity.com itself runs on Udacity. So many people do use it in production. It's a great way to get started. And the things I'll be focusing on this class, you can take with you outside of App Engine. I'm basically going to be talking about high-level concepts. There's a lot of things that App Engine provides that we'll actually be building ourselves. So when we start doing, user registration and cookies and that sort of stuff, we're just going to take that from the top anyway, because I want you to understand the technologies, and it won't be specific to, App Engine or what other framework you'd like to use. So short answer is, yes, you can use it for large-scale projects. I personally don't have a lot of experience doing that. So if you've got more specific questions, hit up the forums.
Great. Another question that Brian Y had was, what kind of challenges you ran into when developing Reddit and Hipmunk?
Okay, so that's actually basically what this whole course is about. So I'm not going to answer that specifically here. I could perhaps do a 7-lecture series about things I learned doing Reddit and Hipmunk. But specifically, Unit 7 is going to be about those types of problems. Unit 7 is how to build websites in the real world, and some of the other things you'll have to think about. How to deal with large numbers of users, customer service, and all those kind of little things that we had to think about getting Reddit off the ground or getting Hipmunk off the ground. Well, I'll spend a whole lot of time talking about that unit in Unit 7. So if you hang with me until then, you'll get your answer.
Okay. The next question is from Einza, and she wants to know how we're going to be graded. In 101, quizzes weren't graded, homework was. And the final counted for half, I believe. And she was wondering what exactly is going to be the structure of this.
Sure. So in this class, there isn't going to be a final. There are going to be homeworks at the end of each unit that basically involve you getting your website online that does things. So the homeworks are the most important thing. If you can pass those homeworks, you know how to build basic websites. And that's the goal of this class. That's what I want you to leave this class being able to do. So the in-lecture quizzes, those don't count towards your grade. Those are basically to keep you engaged, to keep you paying attention, and to sometimes introduce some new concepts. But those aren't required. The homeworks are. So it's important that you figure those out and get those online. Now, you don't actually have to have those homeworks working each week. It's my understanding that we can test those any times. So they have a homework due date, after which we'll post the solutions. But the solutions aren't going to be, when building websites, a lot of the challenge isn't knowing what code to write. It's how to get this thing online, how to get the pieces to fit together. So you're still going to have to figure that out and get these things online. And that's where your grade is going to come from. That's it for office hours. I want to thank everybody who's been hanging out in the forums answering questions. It's been really, really helpful. I know this stuff can be frustrating getting things working. Sean here will be in the forums to help. He's kind of my guy on the ground making sure everything's going smoothly. So if you're stuck, hang out in the forums. I'll be in IRC as well if you want to chat with me during the day. And good luck with the rest of the course.
Real quick. What is the IRC channel? Uh-huh. Some of our students might not know that.
Yes, okay. It's on Freenode, and I believe it is /udacity-cs253. And there should be some information about how to get in there on the forums. So,
okay, great.
All right, guys. Good luck.